Here we're going to have a look at creating some 3D text. We'll do this by creating a spline shape, and if we click on the create tab, click on shapes, you can see we've got lines, rectangles, circles, etc. Here we have text, and I think I'll create this in the front view, so just clicking once in the front view, just zoom this out a little bit so we can see it. Now we need to now apply a modifier, and we've got two options. We can go for extrude, which is the one I'm going to do now. There's our extrude, and you see it's made the text solid, and you can go in the stack, you can go back down to the text and choose a different font. Do bear in mind that some fonts don't react well to being extruded, some don't mind it, so there's a nice font to go with there. Back down to text. Let's change it. There we go. And you can choose sort of kerning, which is how much space there is between the text, leading or leading. So here you can change how much line there is between. There we go. Or basic centre left, italic if it's possible, underline if you need it, and so on. So there's the extrude. Let's zoom extensible so we can see it. And then back up to the extrude in the tab in a modifier stack. Then you can give it more. So if I went onto edged faces, you can see here that we've given it certain number of segments depending on how many we need. Not really need at the moment. And we could have chosen the bevel modifier. Let's delete the extrude so it applies. And we have the bevel modifier, which again does the same thing as extrude. And we'll be looking at the bevel modifier in more detail in the later video.